Walmart's Baby World has lots of TLC for mothers and children. From the big event through baby's early years, Walmart has everything to make it easier for mothers. Furniture, clothing, diapers, toys, toiletries, and many more essentials. All carefully designed by name brands you trust. And with Walmart's everyday low prices, your child can have the very best. Come see how well Walmart takes care of you and your family with even bigger savings during our Tiny Tot sale, now through Saturday.
Recently, in blind taste tests held in malls across the nation, Diet Cola drinkers tested the three leading Diet Colas. Diet Pepsi didn't win. Tab didn't win. Diet Rite Cola did win. In fact, more people preferred the taste of Diet Rite than either of the others. Taste the one that won. Delicious Diet Rite Cola. It's got what it takes to beat the best.
Want something better, yeah, you won't take second best. You want it delicious, for you there's nothing less than Wendy's all-white chicken sandwich. Better you can't find, with a real delicious chicken breast. That's not the processed kind, that's why you're Wendy's kind of people. You want something better, you're Wendy's kind of people.
You're watching Channel 7, WTBW, Evansville.
Premiere of the Gold Monkey.
Big cutter.
Daring pilots.
Hang on.
We'll take you on an unforgettable journey.
You said I could spend the night.
You can. Well, I didn't say I was going to spend it with you.
You can't get off us. We let you.
The Tales of the Gold Monkey. Out of the distance comes a driver's car. Pontiac 2000 for 1983. A car that takes on the road with a smooth, shifting five-speed transmission with overdrive. The ready response of electronic fuel injection. And the steady, willing power of an overhead cam four-cylinder engine. Pontiac 2000. Pure driving pleasure. At Pontiac, we build excitement.
New Jell-O Pudding Pops. Frozen pudding on a stick.
Ooh, tastes good.
Yep. It's a home run with your taste buds and won't strike out with your mom like some snacks do because it's made with real pudding.
New, rich, creamy-tasting Jell-O brand Pudding Pops. All the goodness of a real Jell-O pudding frozen on a stick.
Delicious. And won't strike out with mom.
I could just scream.
What now?
Judy had six cows.
Hold it, bub. Forget something?
Okay, Mom.
And I have to stand on my ear to get her to brush. How did you do that?
Oh, Bobby likes the taste of AIM. I think he even brushes longer.
And checkups?
Great checkups. You can't beat AIM for finding cavities.
Well, either I switch to AIM or we switch kids.
Take AIM against cavities, regular and mint.
Acting on Impulse. Impulse, the new all-over body spray with the reassurance of a gentle deodorant and irresistible fragrance you wear all over every day. So if a man you've never met before suddenly gives you flowers, that's Impulse. Impulse, the new all-over body spray in four irresistible fragrances.
Thank you.
size of it.
Well, it's a big monkey.
Look at his eyes. He has no fear.
Then I shall teach him something.
The legend is true. This man is a god. He is nothing. Nothing but a monkey.
Don't make any sudden moves, Herr Leutnant. Back off. Slowly. Slowly.
The ruby ring and 20 Deutsche Marks to you.
And that's,
$50. American. $50. Sure you want to do this? But remember, this was your idea. Okay.
We'll see you. And raise.
The glass eye?
It's opal, with a sapphire center. Cost me a couple hundred bucks in 36 when Jack and I were flying gold out of Peru. Ah, oh, we were flush then, weren't we, Jack?
It's worth at least 1,200 Deutschmark on the Singapore market. three beautiful ladies.
What are you upsetting me for? I asked you if you wanted to bet your eye, didn't I? Jack! Jack, stay! Did you hear me? I asked you if you wanted to bet your eye, didn't I? What do you mean, no? I showed you my hand. I said, what do you say? You said, ruff, right? Jack, what are you trying to pull? Jack, stay. Yes is ruff. And no is ruff, ruff. Right? Right, so. Jack. What's no? What do you mean, no's ruff?
Oh, I get it. You're trying to switch signals on me. You want everybody to think I lost your eye again.
Well, it won't work. All the world knows ruff is yes, and ruff, ruff is no.
Jack, are you listening to me? Jack.
Oh, darn it, Travis. Too hot for this. Must be over 100.
It's never too hot.
Sam, stop this.
Oh, come on, Sarah. A little nice is not going to hurt.
Sam.
Get out of here, mutt.
Sam, don't hurt the dog, please. Sam, hey, I'll kiss you if that's what you want.
It's more like it, girlie.
Ah! Jack, let go! I'm sorry. I'm very sorry. Bad dog, Jack. Very sorry. He shouldn't have bit you. He just lost his eye, see, and he's a little upset about it. Okay, we'll call it even. You all right, miss? Okay, we won't call it even.
I think it's silly, but ever since I can remember, I had this urge to be a knight. Well, not in armor or anything like that, just in spirit. You know, to help the helpless, to find the wrong and right it. Then somewhere around 13 or 14, it sort of all became an urge to save beautiful damsels in distress. I just wish somewhere in all those books I read about knights and dragons, they'd have warned me about damsels wearing little straw hats.
Thanks one heck of a lot.
Why do I think that sounds sarcastic?
Because that's the way I said it.
Lady, didn't I just save you from a masher?
That masher was my manager. I've handled his hot hands from Liverpool to Singapore to this two-bit island of
Tagataya.
Whatever. And I've done it without your help. Now he's taking the boat to Bora Bora to catch the clipper to Hawaii, and I'm stuck here with two suitcases, $5, an empty stomach. And I want to know what you're going to do about it.
It's Jake.
It's not Jake.
That's my name. Jake.
Oh.
And this pacifist here is Jack.
Thanks for defending me, Jack.
I'm the one who got beat up. Still can't figure out how it happened. I had that guy on the ropes like Lewis had Schmeling, and then...
Then I broke a bottle of champagne over your head. I didn't know it was French champagne. That was an attempt at humor.
Humor?
really.
Look, I didn't want to get stranded in the middle of the South Pacific. Sam may be all hands, but like I said, I can handle him.
I'll bet you can.
What's that supposed to mean?
Take it any way it fits, lady.
It's Sarah. Sarah Stickney what?
Figures. Listen, Sarah Stickney White, the afternoon thunder bumpers up there are real killers. So the sooner I get the goose loaded and out of here, the better. I could use a little help.
Really?
Yes, really. You did sort of delay my departure a little bit by launching that bottle of champagne over my head. Okay, if guilt's not good enough, I happen to be flying to Bora Bora.
And every day, and caring to help you on your way. We're partners in your future. There's a lot you need to know.
Teaching's more than showing how it's helping people grow.
Take part in your children's education. Write NEA for tips.
The company. Quality is job one. This is one of 800 employee involvement groups formed by Ford and the UAW.
This is a real improvement here.
This group reviewed the quality of the new 1983 Mercury Marquis before you could even buy one.
Oh, that's going to be much better than what they had before.
Employee involvement, another reason the quality of our cars has improved an average 48% since 1980.
At Ford, quality is job one.
I love the crunchy wheat taste of Kellogg's Mini Wheats. But the frosting side agrees with the little kid in me.
The whole grain shredded wheat side to me is quite superior. The light frosting kisses my girlish interior.
Kellogg's Mini Wheat Cereals. Whole grain shredded wheat for the adult in you. Light frosting for the kid in you.
For me, the manly side of Mini Wheats is fitting. But the frosting's good too. And I'm not kidding.
Yeah, it's heavy!
I found a way to the gold!
Pitfalled by Activision?
Quick, to the Atari video computer system! Here, show us!
First, climb down the underground passage.
Oh, yeah.
Leap over scorpions.
Set!
Swing over the swamp crocodile!
There, the gold!
Did I mention the tar pits?
Pitfall, a jungle adventure game designed by David Crane from Activision.
Sunday, the premiere of Ripley's Believe It or Not. Visit a cemetery for the rich and famous and meet a woman who is buried in her own sports car.
I'm Jack Palance. Join me and enter the realm of the unexplained.
Ripley's Believe It or Not at 7, 6 Central and Mountain.
Tales of the Gold Monkey, tonight's ABC movie special, will continue in a moment.
Monday, can a man tear a coin or a sprinter beat a horse? The season premiere, that's incredible.
Sandwich, fries, soft drink sundae, that's quite a meal. It's all at your Dairy Queen Brazier store, home of the full meal deal. Sandwich, fries, soft drink sundae, that's the full meal deal.
Now you get a choice with a full meal deal.
You can get it with a hot dog or a fish sandwich.
You can get it with a burger.
Or a chicken sandwich.
And at a great price.
We've got the full meal deal. When you come to Dairy Queen, we treat you right.
This is WTVW, Channel 7, Evansville.
Now we continue with Tales of the Gold Monkey.
It was your boat that brought me, Toto.
Cinto of Kurate! He will never be late again.
My God!
Imusama, Deutsch's Yatsume has arrived. Sosei.
A test.
To become a Koji warrior, one must pass many tests. In this one, you must snatch the ribbon from the cobra's head.
Some of my tests are not so difficult. Some are actually quite pleasurable. Would you like some sake? You wanted to discuss a venture of mutual importance.
Yeah, you've heard of the legend of the gold monkey.
What?
You've heard of the legend of the gold monkey?
Don't tell me that little paper hanger in Berlin has fallen for that one.
Princess Koji, I am a loyal German officer. While I don't indulge in politics, neither can I stand idly by while the leader of my country is insulted.
One must do what one must do.
And I must protest. Most vigorously?
Your protest is accepted.
Good. Now you know of the legend.
I know that somewhere in the Mara Valleys there is supposed to be a gold idol, as big as a house, guarded by giant monkeys. There is also supposed to be a Zulu tribe with the treasure of King Solomon's mine, and the Lost Ark of the Covenant, and...
German intelligence believes the legend of the gold monkey to be genuine. These are decoded reports from two German officers who were here in the Maravillas. They were posing as Dutch artists seeking the idol. Those officers vanished while exploring an island which they thought might be inhabited by giant monkeys.
Which island?
I don't know that yet. Berlin is sending me that information by secret courier.
Willie, despite your act, I know you're not stupid. Now, if this huge gold monkey exists, and we find it, I shall keep it.
Even if the Führer were to pay you 5 times what it is worth as gold?
Why would Hitler do that?
Because, according to legend, the gold idol survived the fire of a volcano.
And you believe that?
1,000 years ago, the Tsetsing monks who supposedly cast this idol knew the secret of blending gold with other metals to make it impregnable to heat. Germany needs such an alloy.
For what?
Rockets, capable of hurtling bombs from one end of the earth to the other. The only thing we're lacking at the moment is a metal capable of withstanding the tremendous heat generated by our fuels.
5 times its gold value?
Yeah.
And what if this gold monkey doesn't exist?
1 million Reichsmarks for your trouble?
Willie, we have a deal.
Me into half the gin mills from Marseille to New Delhi.
Why'd you go?
Wanted to see the world before it gets blown to hell. War's coming. Everyone knows it. Even the isolationists. They just pretend they don't. What about you? Why are you out here?
First thing to learn about the islands is not to ask a man his last name. Second is not to ask where he's from, and the third is...
why he's here, in the first place.
You figured out how you're gonna get a ticket on the Clipper with only $5?
Sam will be cooled off by the time that boat gets into Boragora. He and I may be quits, but he owes me at least a ticket home.
He's not gonna make it.
What?
I mean, in time. He's got a 2-day boat ride from Tangatai to Boragora, and the Clipper takes off at dawn tomorrow.
But when's the next Clipper?
A week. But she'll be flying west. The next eastbound Clipper won't be along for 2 weeks.
You mean I'm going to be stuck at Borgore with no dough for 2 weeks?
Looks that way.
Oh, boy.
I don't know how well you can sing, but you're a redhead and you're American. Out here, that's worth something. I might be able to get you a job singing in the monkey bar.
Monkey bar?
Yeah. It's run by a friend of mine, Louie.
No last name, right?
Right. Most people just call him Bon Chance Louie.
Lucky Louie?
Yeah. He had a date with a guillotine once and lived to talk about it.
You mean somebody tried to cut his head off?
Yeah. French government. Only something went wrong with the guillotine and they had to let him go. It's kind of unwritten French law. fasten your seatbelt, please?
Whew, are we there? Oh, no!
Now, don't worry, it's gonna get a little bumpy for a minute, but that's all. Right, Jack?
Her tough outer shell, or maybe because of it, I knew Sarah Stickney White was putting up a brave front. Under it all, she was just a frightened little girl. Then the port engine quit, and with her in the cockpit was a frightened little boy.
Great cars of Europe have long been priced out of reach. Now Renault closes the gap between European technology and affordability. Introducing Renault Alliance, with the rear wheels behind the rear seat to ride five, not four. And unique pedestal seating for extra legroom. Alliance, European technology now built in America to be affordable. $55.95. Renault Alliance, the alliance of quality and affordability, is here.
Here's Stephanie Powers.
Make me a promise and you better keep it. My makeup does, and my makeup is Moisture Wear. Moisture Wear gives me everything its name promises. Moisture and long wear. It lasts all day, keeps my skin soft and hides tiny dry lines. Long wearing color gives me a fresh, alive glow all day.
Moisture Wear makeup is everything its name promises. It's moisture plus wear all day.
And it's gorgeous.
Where do you get your coconut?
Sun-drenched, naturally sweet coconut.
Snowy white, tree-ripened coconut.
Tender coconut.
You get it in your store, in Peter Paul Mounds and Almond Joy.
Juicy coconut and rich dark chocolate, that's Mounds. Moist coconut, almonds, and creamy milk chocolate, that's Almond Joy. You want great coconut? Get it in your store.
We do.
The Energizer.
Now, get pictures of every cousin.
Everyone, Grandma? Glad I just put the Energizer in here.
Of all leading battery brands, nothing outlasts the Energizer from EverReady. Nothing outsnaps it, nothing outadds, outwalks, outplays, outtapes, outshines, outlasts it. Nothing.
Now me with each grandchild.
No problem. With the Energizer.
The Energizer. Energize for life.
Long life.
Energize me.
Sunday. Meet Matt Houston, Texas-style detective.
Better cock your pistol.
He's dynamic.
I am told you're the best private investigator around.
Determined.
Well, stop pushing me around.
That's not pushing. This is pushing you.
Dangerous.
Okay, dummy. Let's see if your 300 pounds can stop a 45. Come on, I'm begging you.
He's Matt Houston, premiering at 8, 7, Central and Mountain.
Let's do it.
Him, don't fly the goose to Tagataya. Starboard carburetor won't take it. Does he listen to Corky? No, I'm just his mechanic. I'd serve him right if he's down in that sea with the sharks.
Jack, he lost your eye again.
He's lying. Jake? Jake? Jake, I told you that starboard carburetor wouldn't hold.
Corky.
Told you it needed refilling, wouldn't hold the tire.
Corky, in back.
Do you ever listen to Corky? No. And besides that, you lost Jack's eye again.
Which eye?
Sarah Stickney White.
Which eye?
His left.
His right. But I won't tell Jack he couldn't remember.
I remembered. I was just testing you.
Did I pass? Well, then we'll celebrate. I'll grab my stuff and buy you a beer.
I like her, Jake.
You like anyone who buys the beer.
Oh, that reminds me that something I gotta tell you. Told you about the starboard carburetor.
Corky.
Yeah?
Which engine am I working on?
Port. Jake, the starboard carburetor held.
That's right. Port engine quit.
Hey! Someone give me a hand.
You didn't dump that?
You think I'm going to be stuck in the middle of the South Pacific with only the clothes on my back, mister? You're crazy.
The weight of that suitcase could have made the difference between us staying in the air or going in the drink.
It could have. But it didn't.
Two beers. Aren't you going to introduce me to your friend?
Oh, sure. Sorry, Louis, this is Sarah. She's...
Just passing through.
Enchanté.
Hey, Jake, got one. You're too empty, Serge.
Hey, little fella. Come to Papa Louis, huh? Come to Papa Louis.
Hey, qu'est-ce que tu fais? Viens ici. C'est alors.
Just remembered what I had to tell you.
What?
Guess what, Jake? That's Bobby's husband.
You're Bobby's husband? Well, what are you mad at me for? All I did was fly your wife around the islands trying to find you.
I wasn't lost.
Oh, I think I can explain to you. Okay. I won't explain.
Every night she was up in his room telling him how much she missed her husband. And then he didn't mean anything. Girl.
Jake,
I tried to tell you, didn't I, Jake? I told you just as soon as I remembered, didn't I, Jake?
Say?
Well, see, that means he doesn't, Jake. See, one part means no, and two parts...
Corky!
Yeah, Jake?
I need a beer.
Oh, sure, Jake, sure.
That ape tear me apart, and then you growl at the preacher.
sorry, but you're craving for new action. You want new excitement and you want satisfaction. Well, you're gonna feel better when you hear the news. Them network games are waiting for you.
Gold Monkey, starring Stephen Collins, Jeff McKay, and Caitlin O'Haney, will continue in a moment.
Tomorrow, Tony and Chachi get a wild taste of college life. At a network television premiere, Peter Falk is Neil Simon's chief detective.
Oh, boy.
Then, a 2020 exclusive, Pierre Salinger's last interview with Princess Grace. Tomorrow.
Our McRib is swimming in barbecue sauce. McRib sandwich, barbecue flavor really coming across.
McDonald's McRib,
you know it tastes like a no-bones barbecue. All meat, all McRib all through.
Tender pork kind of home-style bun.
With pickles and a taste of onion. McRib cooked up McDonald's way.
Now when you play Atari Scratch and Win cards, you can win a McRib sandwich. Taste the thrill of Atari at McDonald's.
Watching Channel 7, WTVW, Evansville.
Now we continue with Tales of a Gold Monkey.
I see you have lost the poor animal's eye again.
Sarah, this is Reverend Tenboom. He's saving the natives from original sin. Sarah flew in from Tagataya with me, Reverend.
Then you came protected by God's word.
I did. That reverend's way of saying Bible.
Tiki, why don't you prepare the church for evening vespers?
I'd rather prepare for blessing.
All in God's good time, my child. All in God's good time.
Okay, I go prepare church first.
That's so simple, so pure. Much like Adam and Eve must have been in the garden. It is our sacred duty to preserve such innocence.
Then those are your Bibles we lost.
Lost?
Well, we had to dump them.
You dumped my Bibles? Verflixt!
Why would you do such a thing?
I lost an engine, Louis. It's the only way I could stay in the air.
Jake's right. The goose will only lift 3,600 pounds on one engine, and she weighs nearly 3,100 dry. And then there's Jake's weight, and Jack's, and the fuel, and then Sarah's, and... Well, that comes to about, let's see. About 400 pounds, and then in Sarah's suitcase weighs about 50 pounds, and you all barely made it.
You save your suitcase, and you throw out my 1927 Pomperon? Oh!
Well, it made sense at the time. It's not entirely hopeless. There's a chance we can recover some of it. You see, we dumped most of the cargo over an island.
What island? Baku.
What's wrong with Baku?
Not nothing, if you don't mind walking around on a live volcano.
It blows every year about this time. Nobody goes near it.
Including me. Insurance will replace your cargo, Louis, but it won't replace the goose or me.
Sava.
Thank you. Come on, Corky. We got work to do.
Yeah.
do you make of that?
Someone sugared the gas.
Yeah, that's what I figured. Thank God it was only in the port tank.
Jake, why?
I don't know.
Jake, mon vieux. You know, I've been thinking. Going to Baku would in a way be doing God's work. I mean, finding those Bibles.
Well, if that's true, Louis, then I was doing God's work hauling them here, and I almost went in a drink. Besides, hunting for your goodies isn't exactly my idea.
No. But if we're looking for these very important Bibles, you found a little pâté, perhaps a bottle or two of the Pomperon. I do not think the Lord would mind.
No.
Bon. Ça va. Oui. Jake, I don't like to mention this, but you owe me 3 months back rent on the room. And the Corky's bar bill is longer than the Reverend's face. I'll even give you $200 in credit.
$350. Cash. American.
Hey, that's what we need to get Jack's eye back, right?
And I want you to give Sarah a job singing in the bar.
Mon Dieu, will it never end? Can she sing? Eh bien, she's a redhead and American, and it was a very special Pompeo. City.
If you think I'm crazy to fly to Baku in the morning, you're probably right. But you don't have a dog like Jack. That little son of a gun can hold a grudge longer than any woman I've ever met.
I don't know, Jack. Seems to me Jake's doing everything he can to get your eye back. It's not his fault he can't find it. Come on, Jack, be fair.
The Frenchman said he sold it to a bosun on the Hancock.
Some old-timer with no nose bone? Thought his name was Wilson or Winslow?
No Nose Winslow. He's our gunnery chief.
Great. I gotta talk to him.
Remember that time in 34 when he lost your eye to that Chinese bandit and he flew all the way to bet in a snowstorm to get it back? Well, he'll get it back for you. You just gotta have faith, that's all.
You just gotta have faith.
You give blessing now?
Yeah, that would be good. I give blessing now. My God. What can I do for you, my son?
Friday,
and he'll take $350 for it.
What did I tell you, Jack?
He'll believe it when he sees it. I'm gonna check the charts. You need anything?
A couple beers.
Corky.
I know, Jake.
I almost forgot. Picked this up from an American sailor on Tagataya this morning.
Chocolate? American chocolate? Oh. Jake, I haven't had American chocolate since we flew those nuns to the leper colony last
April.
April.
You coming, Jack? See you guys later.
You know, Jack, sometimes you can be real unfair. This is insanity. You sabotaged the plane bringing in my Bibles. Bibles which I need to help me find the island where the idol is.
I didn't know your Bibles were on the plane. Believe me, if I did, my orders were to kill an American spy.
You said you killed him on the dock.
Yeah. But that was after the plane took off and I realized he wasn't on it.
You Gestapo, you don't think you merely act.
I do not have to answer to you.
We shall see about that.
So kleiner Dummkopf.
And what in God's name are you doing in a German naval officer's uniform?
They don't wear uniforms in the Gestapo. This is my cover.
Fine God.
Settle who is in command here.
Come on, Jack, give me a break. I really did think one bluff meant yes. Honest, Jack. What are you doing here?
I heard how you and Francis fought over me.
His name is Francis?
Uh-huh.
Bobby.
Mm-hmm.
Bobby. You lied to me. You told me your husband was a runaway. It wasn't him, it was you.
Well, so I got who did what backwards.
Oh, swell. Your Francis damn near took my head off this morning. Look at me.
Come on, Jake. Let me kiss your boo-boos. Oh,
Jake, are you in now?
Who's that?
What'd you say?
Just a minute.
You keep your mouth shut until I get rid of her. And you can spend the night. Deal?
brought Jack out here and thought maybe you didn't know.
Oh, thanks. Come on, Jack. Come on, Jack. Come on.
I guess he's still a little upset about the eye.
Yeah, I guess so.
Oh, Louis offered me a job.
Did he?
Well, that's terrific.
Yeah, well, it'll keep me honest till Sam gets here.
Yeah.
Or better yet, when Sam gets here. Yeah. You were right, you know, about the boat from Taga...
Tagataya.
It won't be in till tomorrow. Look, Louis told me that you asked him to give me the job, and I just came over here to thank you so much for that.
You would have done the same thing for me.
Oh, sure. Sleep tight. Don't let the bed bugs bite. That's what you're a sucker for, huh? Innocent type. Why does that kind always fool guys like you, hmm? Hey. You said I could spend the night.
You can. Well, I didn't say I was going to spend it with you.
You. Oh, I heard a door slam and I
thought that it might be Jake.
No, just me. But, you've been having now, honey. I'm done.
It serves you right. Here to do a job. Not get involved in... Harry Chested April can't even take care of a one-eyed dog.
Hey, what's your problem?
Got a cold.
There are dozens of cold medicines. Take a pick, Mac.
My cold's in my chest, too.
Oh, you do have a problem. Try Head and Chest. It's brand new.
Head and Chest is different?
Mm-hmm. Different from the leading cold medicine because it helps clear your head and clear your chest.
New Head and Chest clears your head by draining nasal passages so you can breathe easy with no drowsiness. And the difference in Head and Chest is the moisturizing action that loosens and helps get rid of chest congestion.
Hey, Head and Chest works.
Uh-huh. There are dozens of cold medicines. But there's only one named Head and Chest.
New Head and Chest works. Clears your head and clears your chest.
I shouldn't exercise. I'm in no shape for physical fitness.
Mm-hmm. All you need is a shower.
I need more than a shower.
You still don't feel better? Hold up your hand.
I can't lift it.
Here, try this soap. It's cold.
Is this a deodorant soap?
Uh-huh.
Gee, cold smells sensational. And it feels sensational. Look at all this lather. You know what? I do feel better. I never thought I'd feel this good again.
See, and it'll be even easier for you the next time.
No other soap picks you up quite like Coast, the eye-opener.
You're looking at a classic in motion. Pontiac Grand Prix. It
whispers through the wind with a smooth wedge shape. Powered by a standard V6 engine or an available V8, its full coil suspension helps Grand Prix take on the road as if it's riding on air, making driving an exciting, luxurious experience. Grand Prix, a moving classic for 1983. Pontiac, rebuild excitement. Sunday, the premiere of Ripley's Believe It or Not. Visit a cemetery for the rich and famous and meet a woman who was buried in her own sports car.
I'm Jack Palance. Join me and enter the realm of the unexplained.
Ripley's Believe It or Not at 7, 6 Central and Mountain.
I didn't know it at the time, but Sarah Stickney White, Vassar, class of 34, was an American spy. Not exactly a Mata Hari, but kind of cute in her own way.
German radio traffic indicates Wehrmacht and Gestapo, both seeking gold monkey. Island of Baku involved.
Received and understood. Can explore Baku. Will Sam join me?
Some great she does.
Cinder. Sam killed Tagataya. Be careful.
What are you doing up so early?
I'm going with you.
No, you're not.
Well, Louis isn't going. He's scared to death of that volcano. And since I did throw the cargo out, I thought maybe I could help you find it. Besides, it might be fun.
Hey. You look like you've been crying.
Don't be stupid. I'm just allergic to something on the island.
Or someone.
Sarah? Hiya, Jake. Well, she's good as new.
Almost. Porky, I don't know how you do it.
No, it's not. Jake, there's something I gotta...
You gotta tell me.
Yeah, it has to do with the goose.
Starboard carburetor?
No.
Ah. Guten Morgen, Herr Cutter.
Jake, I just remember.
There's somebody here to see me.
I hope you do not mind. I was amusing myself by imagining what it must be like to be a pilot.
Oh, no, I don't mind. I do it all the time myself. What do you want?
To help. I heard you wanted the eye back.
Yeah, I do, but what does that have to do with you?
If I could get it for you, would that be worth, say, a flight to my ship?
Depends. Where's your ship?
Anchored off Takataya. I came over to pick up maps for my captain, which came on the Clipper. You goose could save me a day getting back.
Yeah? Where's the eye?
I have it. Won it from that frog sailor after you left the game. It is in my locker on board the ship.
Fritz? You got a deal.
Good.
A gold idol as big as a house.
I've told you 1,000 times. It's two. It's out here, somewhere, on one of these islands.
It better be, Willie, because I don't like eliminating Jake Cutter. I've grown a little fond of him.
Berlin was quite clear. The Gestapo agent is taking orders from me. And I commanded him to keep Jake Cutter and his plane away from here. Not to kill him. Like you, I rather enjoy having Jake around, even if I do suspect he is an American agent. It looks quiet enough.
He's going to erupt.
When?
Maybe next year. Maybe today.
So, as they say in the travelogues, we flew to the beautiful island of Baku. What they didn't say is we flew with a German naval officer who was a liar. A pretty redhead who was after more than just a peek at the South Pacific. A dog who was obsessed with getting his eye back. And a mechanic who was, well, who was just badly in need of a drink.
They were a little out of sync.
Stayed in Boragora.
And let you burn up my engines? No siree, Bob. And besides, what are you going to do when that starboard carburetor quits, huh?
She's running fine. Stow your toolkit in the aft locker and keep an eye on Fritz back there.
Jake, I don't like being back there with
him. Who's captain here? I want your toolkit in the aft locker and your tail back there, now.
Okay, Jake. All right. All right.
You really are something. Corky's jumping because he needs a drink. But all you know is he irritates you, so you climb all over the little guy.
Listen, Sarah Stickney White. Corky and I have been together for a long time, ever since he pulled me out of a burning trimotor in Guatemala in 33. You've known him one day. That time I've learned how to take care of him and how to keep his boozing to a minimum, and damn, what am I explaining all this to you for anyway?
I don't know.
And why are you so mad at me? Last night you were trying to get into my room.
I was not. And even if I was, what would you have done with two of us in there? Don't answer that.
Two of you? You saw
saw Bobby leave my room.
You're jealous.
Jealous? Jake Cutter, you are the most ego-centered man I've ever had the displeasure of meeting.
Jake wasn't really mad at me.
Just because a girl tries to be friendly, you think she's making a pass at you. But where I come from, girls don't make passes.
You got a mirror?
They wait for the guy to... What?
A small mirror, a makeup mirror. I need one.
You really think I look like the type of woman who goes off to a volcanic island with a makeup mirror?
There thinks I'm flying him to Takataya.
Why would he think that?
Because that's what I told him. See, he lied to me about having Jack's eye, so I lied to him. I think it all has something to do with you.
Me?
That engine we lost yesterday was sabotaged. There's only three reasons why somebody would do that. To kill me, Jack, or you. It was you.
You know, you really ought to write for the movies. Your fantasies are incredible.
Maybe. But any minute now, Fritz is going to realize I've been slowly changing our heading, flying away from Takataya and toward Baku. And if I'm right about my fantasy, he's going to know I'm on to him. I don't fight well, Sarah, when I don't know what I'm fighting for. Or who?
Concept and high technology have come together to create a whole new generation of Zenith television, presenting the new compact TVs. All the picture brilliance of the big screen Zeniths, but in compact sizes. And an exciting collection of contemporary cabinet designs. 19 new models, including Zenith's new component TV system. The new Zenith Compact, part of the new generation from Zenith, where the quality goes in before the name goes on.
Best beer for the best time of the day, Miller High Life.
Sunday, meet Matt Houston, private investigator.
I'm just asking questions. See, that's how I know I'm a detective.
He's reckless.
Bang!
Houston, this car does not start.
Don't do this to me.
Discriminating.
Nice little boat your friend's got here.
Loyal.
You could have come to me. We could have worked something out.
Tough.
Really make my skin crawl, you know that?
He's one of a kind. Matt Houston premieres at 8, 7 Central and Mountain.
Tonight's movie, Tales of a Gold Monkey, will continue in a moment.
Saturday, the season premiere of T.J. Hooker.
I know this guy, and I know his victims.
Hooker's second chance at love is threatened by a killer. And a special two-hour love boat sets sail for the South Sea Islands Saturday.
Come on along on Saturday night.
Brock's knows the secret of old-fashioned candy store candy. Fresh, good-tasting ingredients. That's the secret of Brock's toffee candy. Chelsea chips. Delicious, crisp English toffee. Rich with real butter. Crunchy with fresh roasted almonds and smothered with Brock's real chocolate.
Mmm,
That's old-fashioned toffee taste. Ooh, Chelsea chips. A chip off the old Brock.
Brock's, the candy store candy.
This is Channel 7, WTVW, Evansville.
What was that?
These islands are full of animals the world's never seen.
Yeah! One of the Bibles from the shipment.
Sagase.
Hey!
Genesis is missing.
Oh, my amor. Willie, don't you think it's time you tell us what was in the Bible?
The illustration of the Garden of Eden in one of those Bibles is the copy of the last painting our men sent back before they disappeared. Berlin believes it is of the island they were about to explore, an island inhabited by monkeys. We must find one of those Bibles in order to find the island with the monkeys.
No, we don't.
For Uncle Sam?
Well, not for Uncle Adolf.
And you really believe this legend about a gold monkey 100 feet high?
It's not gold. It's an alloy. An incredibly heat-resistant alloy. And it doesn't really matter if I believe it or not. FDR does. And evidently, so do the Germans.
Hang on. With only a port engine.
Sorry, Jake. I just couldn't shoot him in the back.
It's okay. At least he wasn't armed.
Thank you.
up there, somewhere! The monkeys proved it!
The Fuhrer is depending upon me to find it for Germany, and I will not let him down!
How long?
2, maybe 3 hours.
Make it 1.
Jake!
Stick close to the goose.
Where are you going?
After Fritz.
Why?
Now I can't leave him here with the island about to blow up, no matter what he's done. I gotta give him a chance to save his hide.
I'm going with you.
No, you're not. You're gonna stay here and guard Corky and the goose. So are you.
Jake, I've got this thing pretty well figured out.
If you don't do as I tell you, I'm going to take you over my knee and spank you.
Women.
Men.
Children. They're all children.
Jack! Jack!
Unless you want that monkey for company.
You animal. If you kill Jack, I'll get you. I swear it.
Why are you whispering now, Bella?
Jake! 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 Jake!
you not to leave the goose?
Untie me!
Discovered Sanka ground coffee. Ground coffee lover Mike Johnson.
Tastes great.
Ground coffee lover Virginia Buckland.
That's good.
Enjoy Sanka brandy caffeinated coffee, ground roasted for a rich, fresh, pert, delicious cup of coffee. So take it from real ground coffee lovers like John Russ Kelly.
That's good.
For fresh, pert flavor, discover Sanka ground coffee for yourself.
All the times you've made sure Dad didn't oversleep. For all the times you've met Andy at the bus when you could have met him at the door. Though you'd eat dry dog food and not complain, I feel better giving you Gainsburgers.
Gainsburgers is made with the real meat dogs love, plus extra oil for your dog's coat.
For making Janie feel safe, away from home, I feel better giving you Gainsburgers.
I need help. My husband won't come home.
Pac-Man, I can help.
Get him, Pac-Man!
Stand back.
This is the official tabletop version of Midway's Pac-Man.
It looks the same.
And it plays the same. Monsters, power capsules, sounds, even displays best score. And best of all,
you can take Pac-Man home.
Official Midway Pac-Man for one or two players. The arcade game you can take home with you from Coleco.
Since 1975, lettuce is up 61%.
Hey, that's a lot of cabbage.
Mushrooms, 46%. Grapes, 82%.
It's fruitless.
In today's economy, you need Ziploc storage bags. With their unique seals, Ziplocs are zipped to lock, and they stay locked, so foods stay fresher longer.
What's up, Doc?
Carrots, 138%.
Oh, no.
Ziploc storage bags. There's no better way to protect your investment.
Friday, Sean Connery is the classic Bond in Goldfinger.
Shocking.
Drop the gun.
You found the gold monkey.
Yeah.
I'm going after Jack. Can you handle this?
Of course I can.
You know, this doesn't change anything. You're still getting that spanking. You old son of a gun! Let's get out of here. One bark is yes. Jack!
Catch!
your Gestapo friend was going to divert Jake Cutter.
One should never rely on the Gestapo.
The preacher.
I had heard that you had found something interesting on Baku.
The gold idol.
Ah, gold idol, oh boy.
Gold.
Yeah.
Congratulations, Miss Jane. Sarah. Cokey.
Louis, what do you think it's worth?
Give you a couple of hundred francs for it.
Couple of hundred francs for a gold idol?
For a gold idol that is made of brass.
Brass, monkey.
Brass? Impossible.
Why don't you rub it and see? Permit me. Jake, can I go get a beer now?
Yeah, sure, go ahead.
Over a lousy piece of brass.
Well, I get the feeling a lot of boys are going to be dying over things like that before too long.
Not if I can help it.
My God. It is brass.
If you will excuse me, young lady, I will take my leave now. It's been a rather tiring day.
I think I will go home and bless Tiki now.
Time for blessing.
I thought he blessed Tiki earlier.
I didn't have time to get around to it. Well, how about another beer?
Jack?
He'll feel better when you get his eye back from that bosun in the Hancock tomorrow.
The Hancock?
Yeah, she's anchoring for Weekend Liberty.
Not the Hancock. She's sailing for the Philippines on emergency orders.
Jack, stay.
Be fair. How could I have known? Look, I'll get your eye back. I promise, even if I have to fly all the way to the Philippines. Trust me.
Well, you see, that means no, Jake. One bark means no, and two barks means...
Corky!
Jake?
Thank you.
some of your beer?
Sure.
They have found it.
Then all we have to do is take it from them.
Don't bother. It is made from brass.
All that effort just for a brass monkey.
Maybe you're right. Maybe we were all a little cuckoo to believe such a legend.
Stay tuned for scenes from upcoming episodes of The Gold Monkey.
Pontiac hasn't forgotten what driving is all about. The 1982 Firebird is a car charged with driving excitement. With great features like a 4-speed manual transmission, quick ratio power steering, power front disc brakes, and a responsive 2.5-liter 4-cylinder engine with electronic fuel injection. All standard, and all at a surprisingly affordable price. Pontiac's new Firebird. Now the excitement really begins.
When you need a little lift, but you just can't take a break, chew Wrigley's Spearmint Gum. The cool, refreshing feeling of Wrigley's Spearmint Gum puts a little lift in everything you do. That good, smooth chewing, that crisp, clean taste, that Wrigley's Spearmint pickup is going for you.
Wrigley's Spearmint Gum really keeps you humming. Wrigley's Spearmint Gum keeps you humming along. Wrigley's Spearmint Gum really keeps you humming. Wrigley's Spearmint Gum keeps you humming.
Soup is a harvest of nerves.
You got it?
It was the worst job interview in recorded history. What a gargoyle.
But wait a minute.
They said they'd call me this afternoon.
Well, here, have something to eat.
Oh, I couldn't. My stomach's in knots.
Come on, it's Campbell's cream and mushroom soup. You can always eat soup.
Did you know that one of the most digestible ways you can get your nourishment is delicious Campbell's soup?
Mm. See, now you look like you can handle it.
You know something? I do feel better.
I dream what I don't do.
Tempest, the story of a father and a daughter who went from dreaming dreams.
Maybe I'll just find myself an island.
Why can't you take me?
To living them.
Isn't this just so perfect?
Who found love.
I've never been in love.
Magic.
Show me the magic.
And one another. Tempest, a surprising comedy, rated PG. Check newspapers for a theater near you.
1 week from tonight on the Tales of the Gold Monkey.
They're coming after us, Jake.
I know, Corky, I know. Come, Corky!
Do I know you?
You know which way they took Corky, don't you, Jack?
He'd like to join me.
I didn't come here for a bath.
I may pass out.
Jake! Jake!
And on Wednesday, October...
over 13.
You're not that crazy, are you?
Jake Cutter's adventures continue.
No bomb could be as powerful as those Germans said.
I have some experiments to conduct for them.
We don't have anything that size in development.
I take my dueling seriously. Herr Cutter.
It's an unforgettable journey.
Come on! 9, 8.
On the Gold Monkey. At 8, 7 Central and Mountain, Joni and Chachi hit a wild fraternity party and a network television movie premiere. Peter Falk is Neil Simon's chief detective. Then, a 2020 exclusive last interview with Princess Grace by Pierre Salinger.
This is David Hartman. Tomorrow, news from Lebanon. Our teenage drunk driving series continues. Also, Brooke Shields and Friday Lou Rawls on Good Morning America.
Stay tuned for Dynasty, following an ABC News brief. Next.